Hello to my wonderful subscribers. Welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to do I want to call it an unexpected haul because I did some collecting of beauty items over the last maybe 3 weeks or so, and I want to share them with you. A couple of them I have tried already, and a couple of them I have not tried yet. So I'll talk to you, I'll give you guys what my thoughts are so far to the ones that I've tried. The ones that I haven't tried yet, I will definitely let you know. For those of you who are wondering what is on my face today, I am wearing the Tarte In Bloom palette on the eyes, Inglot gel liner number 77, No Name False Lashes, which you might see in an empty soon. And then I'm wearing my Too Faced Melted Liquid Lipstick in Melted Peony. This was like their original Melted line before they came out with the Melted Matte. And the highlighter I'm wearing today is a highlighter that is in this haul. So you will definitely see that in this haul. So with that said, I'm just going to dive right in. Let's get this started. So first of all, I want to show you what I picked up from Sephora. I have not done yet, the VIB sale is not until Monday, and this is just stuff that I picked up from a variety of different places, so it's not just specifically Sephora, so I haven't really hit the VIB sale yet. I'm hoping to hit the VIB sale. I don't know if I will. I haven't really made a decision. There's not really too much I really need, and after this haul that I show you, I'm not really looking for anything right now, so I may skip this VIB sale and wait for November, but we'll see. I'm not making any promises, but we'll see. But first off, I wanted to show you that I made the investment to pick up the Cinema Secrets Quick Drying Rinse Free Formula Antimicrobial Disinfectant Brush Cleaner. This is in the large 32 fluid ounce size. It goes for about $40 Canadian. I tried this last year. I bought the 27 fluid ounce size version of this, and it really it worked well. It really cleansed my brush, my brushes, especially my face and my eyeshadow brushes. But it was so intense that if you got a drop of this on your nail polish, it would literally eat away the shine at the nail polish. It was unbelievable. It's really high in alcohol. I'm pretty sure it's really high in alcohol. Does it even say the ingredients on here? I don't think so. It's got directions. Oh, it's 99.99 antimicrobial disinfectant at 30 seconds contact time. So yeah, 99.99% antimicrobial, that is some intense shit. This stuff can kill anything in your brushes, and that's why I love it. At first I wasn't a fan of it because it was so intense. Then after I finished the 27 fluid ounce and I went back to my MAC brush cleaner, which I'm currently going through right now, I noticed that the MAC brush cleaner is not as intense as this, and it takes a lot longer for the MAC brush cleaner to really get rid of shit on your brushes. And, you know, whether I'm doing my own makeup or I'm doing my family member's makeup or somebody I know, it's hard for me to kind of, you know, fight with a brush cleaner if I need to use that same brush on a different color or whatnot. So the MAC one I'm noticing is quite weak compared to this one, and I prefer now this one more than the MAC one, which is strange because when I first tried this one, I preferred the MAC one, but then when I started using more waterproof makeup products, I'm noticing that this one is the one to use for disinfecting and cleaning brushes opposed to the MAC one. I know it's kind of crazy. You know, at first I wasn't a fan, but now I am, and I made the investment because this stuff is it's a makeup lover's dream and godsend when it comes to cleaning your makeup brushes and sponges. So I don't think I'd use that on my sponges. I would just use it more on my brushes. But if you dilute it a tad bit with water and you use it on your sponge, I'm sure it wouldn't be a bad thing, you know. So I haven't tried it with a sponge, so I can't really say, but the brushes works phenomenal. So another tool that I want to show you guys that I picked up is I bought 4 of these eyebrow razors on Amazon. I think there was buy 12 for $6. I can't remember. Excuse me, really inexpensive. I bought 3 of these at Sephora last year for $15. So 3 of these were $15 at Sephora. I said, there's no way I'm going to, you know, spend that much money on just 3 razors. It's unbelievable. So I went on Amazon, I found them. I originally purchased an order of 32 razors of these, and they didn't come in. I don't know if it was against policy to coming into Canada. I don't know if it was a shipping issue. So I had to reorder from a different company. I ended up getting my money back from the other company, and I ended up getting it through a different company instead. The ship time is quite long, but it's worth it because then you're not having to dish out an arm and a leg for razors. I use these to shave my face, and yes, before you second guess or rewind the video for me to say it again, I do shave my face. I only shave my face around the sides of my face here, just around the sides here, because that is where I get most of my peach fuzz, and I find that once I get rid of that peach fuzz, it really helps my application of makeup a lot better. So I don't shave my face often. I think I do it mainly once every 2 months, once every 3 months, depending, you know, how fast the hair grows back. Since I stopped taking the hair, skin, and nails vitamin, because that was making my hair grow super fast, especially on my facial sideburns here, it's kind of slowed down a bit, so I'm not having to do it as often. But I do like to do it, you know, once every 2 months or three, just to kind of make it more easier for my makeup application, especially when I have big events for pictures and whatnot. I will do it like a week before, and it'll last me for a good couple months before I have to do it again. So I did pick these up on Amazon. I don't know if these are really that great because I haven't tried them from Amazon. I did try them at Sephora through another brand, but I figured, you know, it's the same thing. All it is just a tiny razor blade on a stick. Like, what can go wrong? We'll see how sharp they are and how well they get the job done, but I will keep you guys posted on these, because if they do the job properly, I will definitely always go back to these to restock, because they're so much more affordable than having to spend $15 at Sephora for like three razor blades, which I think is ridiculous. Okay. So I have made a couple of purchases at Sephora, one being the brush cleaner. The second one is, this is the last, I think, Sephora purchase so far. You guys have seen it on my channel so already. I made a video about it. This is the Becca Prosecco Pop Skin Perfector. And if you guys don't know where Prosecco Pop came from, this is a highlighter that Jaclyn Hill co-created with Becca Cosmetics. It is the sister to Champagne Pop, of course, which Jaclyn Hill also co-created with Becca. This is more of like a goldy champagne color, whereas Champagne Pop is like a rosy gold champagne, like a peachy gold, not rosy gold. It's peachy gold. So I saw this in full size in single pan form online, and I said, oh, hell to the no, I am not going to skip on that, because I never picked up the limited edition palette from her. But I did want the Prosecco Pop highlight. I just didn't think the palette was worth getting just the Prosecco Pop highlight along with, you know, Champagne Pop and those freaking blushes. Like, I thought it was ridiculous. So I ended up waiting, and I found this online and I picked it up. It is a beautiful, beautiful gold highlight. Like, I've swatched this already in a video, and I'm pretty sure I included it in my favorites this week, but this is like a beautiful gold highlight, and it is perfect. I use this all the time. I mix it with other highlights. I'm not using it today. I'm wearing a different highlight that I will show you, but that is what I have been loving as well. But, you know, this is just, it's just stunning. If you don't have that palette, definitely pick up Prosecco Pop single pan form. It is so worth it. I think it's beautiful. Like, I'm sure girls with lighter skin tones can pull this off, but girls with darker skin tones also can pull this off. It's very versatile for, you know, a wide range of skin tones. So definitely check that out. Like, that's beautiful. I'm not using a light directly on my face today, just because there's a little bit of daylight out, so I'm trying to use the daylight for now. But that is what it looks like in regular daylight. So I made a trip to the drugstore, and I found a couple of things that I wanted to show you. First off, I picked up this Essie nail polish in Peach Side Babe. I have not worn this yet. It's a new polish, so I'm hoping to use it in the next day or two. I'm going to change out this color that I'm wearing today. You know, peaches are in this season. Like, it's been a year of like corally peachy colors, so I'm excited. I had to throw out a peachy Essie polish that I had. It was called Hot as Hello. If you've seen my previous empties, you've seen it in there. It was a gorgeous peachy color. Had to get rid of it. It was too old. I think it was like, you know, halfway or three quarters of the way down. So by, you know, by that time, and because of its age, it was just not, it wasn't working well to wear it. So I had to get rid of it, and I did get rid of it, but I replaced it with this baby right here. So I'm excited to try this out. Essie is another brand that I do enjoy using. Not as much as I do OPI, but Essie is definitely a good option as well. So another thing I found at the drugstore, because, you know, I like to go hunting, is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder, because I don't know why I can't talk. This is in the shade Precious Petals. So it's their highlighting powders that they came out with that everybody and their mother is talking about. I've been wearing it for a while now. I have it all over my cheekbones. I have it on the tip of my nose and the Cupid's bow. This is like a rose gold champagne. Like, that's how the best way I can describe it. I've included this in my favorites last week, I believe. And just, do you see that? It's just got this, like, honestly, the pigmentation and the blendability and butteriness is definitely up to par with the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfectors. So if you can't afford a Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector and you can get your hands on the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighters, I'm like on the hunt to find the other one of these, because the other one of this one is like the gold highlighter, and I'm like, you know me. If you've been here for a while and you've seen my videos for a while, you know that I'm about that golden glow highlight. So if I can find the gold one of this, I will be set, because when I went and found this at the drugstore, this was the only shade left. So I was like, damn, I'm like, I wish I had the other one too, but it's fine. I will try and find it when I'll visit again to the drugstore just to see what's going on there, and hopefully they'll have it. But yeah, no, this is like beautiful, like pigmentation, blendability. I use this on my face today. It was just beautiful, stunning, without even using Fix Plus. You don't even need to use Fix Plus. Like, this is just a regular swatch. So you can imagine what Fix Plus would do to something like this. It's just a beautiful, rosy toned, champagne-y highlight. It's gorgeous. I love it. It's doable on different skin tones. I mean, I'm more olive and it definitely looks decent on me. You can go heavy handed on it. You can even do light handed on it. Like, I did a light hand on it today just because, like, I'm not really going out to a fancy place. So I just went really, really light handed on this, and then on the tip of my nose and my Cupid's bow, but I can go ham with this, and it just doesn't do justice, like, for a drugstore option. In Canada, these are a little bit more expensive. I think they go for about $6 to $7, depending on where you find them, but they're still more affordable than your Becca Shimmering Skin Perfectors, which are like $50 Canadian. So, I mean, it's all up to you on what you want to spend your money on, but like, if you're looking for a more affordable option, you don't want to spend that kind of money right now, you can't afford it, whatever the case may be, this is a beautiful, beautiful, budget-friendly option. And I'm so happy that I found this, because this is like, has been one of my favorites since I picked it up. By far, beautiful. Okay, so another couple things that I picked up at the drugstore. You guys know me, I'm like a skincare fanatic. I love everything skincare related. You know, serums, oils, masks, cleansers, you know, I can go from point A to point B in less than 30 seconds. It's really hard for me to say no to skincare because I have a skincare obsession. That's pretty much what it is. A lot of people say, well, you know, why do you have a skincare obsession? Like, you have a makeup obsession. Well, not to knock anyone down, but if you don't take care of your skin, your makeup is going to look like shit. I'm just being honest. So, you know, for the last, I would say, 2 to 3 years, I've been really working hard on my skin, and it's been paying off, where I have gotten rid of a lot of my really deep, severe, deep tissue acne. I see a dermatologist every few months. I take a serious medication that I have to be vigilant on. Vigilant? Is that the right word? I don't even know. So with that said, I like to use topical products on my skin to kind of help what I'm doing in the inside also on the outside. With that said, at the drugstore, there was a sale buy 3 for $5. So I picked up the Kit facial masks. I've tried these before. They're pretty good. They're not bad at all. Like, they're pretty decent. You get 3 for $5. And like, if you're having a slumber party with your girlfriends, this is actually a great way to kind of chill out and relax together. I just buy them for me, like, whenever I feel like doing a mask, like a one-time mask thing. So I picked up the clay mask in Dead Sea Salt. This is supposed to deeply cleanse and soften skin with the Dead Sea Salt clay mask. So this is like a deep cleanse. I also picked up the aloe vera face mask. This is an also deep cleansing mask, combines the moisturizing properties of aloe vera and exfoliating properties of peach kernel extract for a deep clean. And then I picked up the warming mask. This is the sauna clay. So this one is indulge in the spa-like clay mask to help remove unwanted dirt from deep within your pores. So this is like another deep cleansing mask. So I picked 3 deep cleansing masks. What can I say? I do have quite a few hydrating masks, so I really didn't think I needed those. But these are just great one-time uses if you want something quick, nothing too fancy. These are perfect. I picked these up at the drugstore, Rexall drugstore here in Canada. So if you have a Rexall by you, they do sell the kit line. So that is another item that I did pick up. Okay, so another thing I picked up at the drugstore, this was on sale. Again, I found it at Rexall. This is the new L'Oreal Hydra Genius Liquid Daily Care. 72-hour continuous hydration for oily skin, mattifying aloe water and hyaluronic acid. So this is basically a moisturizer you put on before your makeup. So normal to oily skin faces external factors such as pollution, UV rays, and excessive cleansing that can damage skin protection barrier, causes loss of moisture and increase in oil production. As a result, complexion is unbalanced and overly shiny. I can get overly shiny fast, especially in the summertime. Hydrogenous mattifying daily liquid care for normal to oily skin, formulated with aloe water and 3 sources of hyaluronic acid, provides 72 hours of continuous hydration and mattifying action for mattified, hydrated, refresh skin and healthy glowing look. Where's the directions here? Does it even say? Visible. How to use. Use every morning and night after cleansing. Gently smooth over face. I wouldn't use this every night only because it's mattifying, and if it's mattifying, then I would use it more for under my makeup, because, you know, at least I know that my makeup is not going to kind of go anywhere, or it's not going to, like, my oils are not going to come out. I would just use it in the morning before my makeup. Look at the bottle and how beautiful this looks. Like, L'Oreal is really good when it comes to their packaging. It's a glass bottle. No joke. This is a 3.4 fluid ounce bottle. So that's quite a bit of product. I picked this up for $13.99 at Rexall. This was on sale. I think it's because it's a new product. They want people to start buying it and trying it. So I think regular prices is about $19, but I did get it on sale for $13.99. So we'll see how this puppy goes. I have not started using it yet. I'm waiting for the weather to get a little bit more hotter, because that's probably best when this will be, you know, used for its peak, you know, result, if you guys know what I mean. I picked up a liquid eyeliner from L'Oreal as well. This is the Voluminous Liquid Eyeliner Cat Eye Look. This is Blackest Black, number 300. I don't have a liquid eyeliner. I got rid of the ones that I had. They were either too old or dried out, or whatever the case was. So I just wanted something that I can, you know, use for myself in particular, not really for anyone else but me. And I am excited to open this up. So we'll see how this one goes. I'm trying really hard not to go and buy the Kat Von D liquid eyeliner that everybody talks and raves about because it's so expensive. So I wanted to try first drugstore, see how I feel about it, and then we'll decide if I'm going to go to bigger and better products in Sephora when it comes to that. Last two products from the drugstore, you guys. So, you know, when you're browsing the drugstore and you're going aisle by aisle, you're bound to come up across maybe products that you never thought you would buy or decide to purchase unless they were on sale, and these are two of them. So I picked up the Nip and Fab Skin Dragon's Blood Fixing Plumping Mask. This was on sale for $12. Normally it's like $24.99. So this is basically an instant moisture shot wrinkle plump effect gel with gel mask with hyaluronic acid and dragon's blood. This is, I've never tried yet, haven't tried it. I will be trying it very soon. And I also picked up the Nip and Fab Bee Sting Fix Lifting Mask. This is Extreme Plump Lift Effect Mask with Bee Venom and Skin Tensor. So here's another one. I'm a little nervous to try this, I'm not going to lie, because I've never tried any products that I'm aware of with bee venom. So I'm not sure how well my skin is going to react to that. And I've never been stung by a bee, so I don't even know if I'm allergic or not. Funny, I know. So, sorry, I had an itch in my ear, you guys. I wasn't, like, picking my ear or anything. There's, like, an itch right here, and it's making me, like, want to sneeze. So, I've tried Dragon's Blood before because I've had Dragon's Blood in my Peter Thomas Roth. I had this, like, gel cream from them from, like, a couple years ago, and that was amazing. It did such a great job, but... So Dragon's Blood I'm not really worried about, but the bee venom one I'm kind of like on the fence. So I think what I might do is I'm probably going to test this out first on like my wrist here, just to see like if my skin will react to it, and then if it does, then I may not use this, but we'll see how it goes. If all goes well, I'm gonna try it out. I'm gonna follow directions. They say that the mask is only to be worn for up to 10 minutes, so I wouldn't go more than that. A lot of the times, the masks that I use, like hydrating masks or clay masks, I will put on longer than what the box says, because with my skin, I can use the extra hydration or extra deep clean. But when it comes to like stuff like this that has like a venom in it from an animal that I've never been bitten by, I don't know if I'm allergic to or whatnot, I wouldn't really take that risk. So I always follow the directions on the box. Personally, for me, my tip to you guys is that if you've never tried the product, I would always follow the direction on the box than, you know, making up your own time to leave the mask on, just because you don't know how your skin's gonna react to it. And, you know, once you know how your skin's gonna react to it, then you can, you know, fix the time you leave it on your face for whatever you feel comfortable with. But until you really like try it out a few times, definitely follow the directions, because you never know. And make sure you always test patch on your wrist first, just to make sure that your skin doesn't completely freak out on it. So yeah, that is my tip to you when it comes to skincare, like masks and stuff like that. So I made an order on, what is it called? Morphe. So I picked up a couple of highlighting brushes and I picked up a palette. So the first highlighting brush that I picked up is, this is the R36. I just love this brush because it's got like a tapered point. It's kind of like the bigger version of like a crease brush, like a crease blending brush. It's just a bigger version of that, but I wouldn't use it in my crease. I use it on the tops of my cheekbones, down the bridge of my nose, on my cupid's bow. This is like for highlighting. Actually, all these brushes are for highlighting. I just didn't have proper highlighting brushes and I really wanted them, so I ended up biting the bullet and picking them up through Morphe. I also picked up the fan brush, which is the R12. Like, these brushes are still new. Like, I have not even like used them yet, so they're still new. The only one that I've used is the one that I showed you first. This is the R36. And then finally, the last one that I picked up is the R31. And this is another highlighting brush that you can use for your cheekbones, the bridge of your nose, your cupid's bow, even your, you know, forehead or above your eyebrow. So these are the three highlighting brushes I picked up because I really didn't have proper, the only highlighting brush I really had that was proper highlighting is the Anastasia A23 brush. And that one can pick up a lot of product at times because I'm pretty sure the tips of those, that brush has like a, it's a faux tip, like there's like, it's a faux fur. So I didn't really want to always use that, especially if I want something a lighter, then I can use the fan brush, you know. I do have a fan brush, but it is like a bigger fan brush, so it does pick up a lot more product. So yes, these are my three highlighting brushes I've added to my collection. Morphe is a great option for brushes if you guys are in the market to purchase brushes. Honestly, I don't think I've ever had an issue with Morphe brushes. The Morphe brushes that I still like, that I currently own, are the fat kabuki one, and then like the small, it's a small version of the MAC that you can contour with, but it's rounded, so it's kind of like a bigger version of this, a little bigger version that you can use to contour with. I have that one as well. I don't think I have any other Morphe ones, if I'm not mistaken. I don't think so. But I'd like to expand my Morphe brush collection because these are awesome and I really enjoy the ones I did have. So Morphe was the option for me when it came to purchasing brushes. So that is definitely on my list. Another thing I picked up from Morphe was their 35R palette. This came out the day that I placed the order. So I think that's what kind of got me to place the order was this palette. And you'll see why. You will see why. So this is what the 35R palette looks like. It's basically a neutral, it's a neutral gold palette, but it is stunning. I have the 35O palette, which is very stunning as well. But this palette has got basically all you need for a neutral matte look and a neutral shimmer look. Your shimmers are here and your mattes are here. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4 rows of mostly mattes, maybe 2 in here or more like a satiny finish. Then you have 1, 2, 3 rows of shimmers that you can work with all these matte shades. So they are stunning. And I'm going to swatch them for you so you guys can see how stunning they can be. Like, I have no words. Do you see that? Let's do one of the matte ones. See? Beautiful. Honestly, I think that Morphe palettes are pretty decent for their price. Some people don't like them. I don't know why. I know some people don't like them only because people are affiliated and they're trying to push product on you. I can tell you right now, I'm not affiliated with them whatsoever. I don't make any money off of them. I don't have an affiliate code. And as you can see, these shadows are beautiful, like stunning, stunning. Like I don't know how people can say that they're not great quality. So, with that said, I'd like to just point out that I'm not affiliated with them at all, and I think they're a great company. They package their palettes very, very securely. I've never had a problem with getting a palette from Morphe and it breaking in the middle of shipping. When I get my palette and my stuff in the mail, everything is properly bubble wrapped. This palette is bubble wrapped all around, stuck in a sleeve, then put in a box and bubble wrapped again in the inside the box. So their shipping standards are absolutely phenomenal. I've never had an issue with shipping. I've never had an issue with the quality. It's really, really stunning. And I didn't even order this, but they actually threw in like a travel size Morphe lip cream polish. I've never tried this before. I don't even know what the color is. Your everyday lip cream polish in your favorite shade with a glossy finish. To be honest, you guys, I've never ever tried this before, so I don't even know. I don't even know. Oh, this is pretty. Oh, wow. That's like a perfect nudie pink. Smells like vanilla, basically. So this is something that I could definitely pop into my purse and keep for emergency purposes, because like this is just a stunning nude pink, which I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put this in my purse. So yeah, they threw this in like for free for what I bought, so I was actually quite impressed. Morphe is a pretty great company, I think, and I know that Jaclyn Hill is working on a palette with them, and apparently they should be coming out with a palette with her in the future. I know she's had palettes with them in the past. I don't know what this palette's gonna look like. I know that there was like rumors on social media what it was gonna look like, and I don't know if it's still gonna be the same, but nonetheless, I think Morphe is a great brand, and that's my own opinion. So you guys, judge on how you want, but personally for me, I enjoy Morphe products, and I'm really glad that I picked that palette up. It's pretty much all you need in a palette, especially if you're a neutrals girl. This is all you would need. If you're a neutrals a lover and you're a gold lover, this is pretty much all you need in your life. That's all you would need. So, anyways, moving on. So I made an order to Kylie Cosmetics. I know, you guys, I'm not understanding why. Well, no, I am understanding why I made an order, because let me tell you something. Once upon a time, I used to boycott Kylie Cosmetics. I then, waited a good amount of time. She kind of, fixed some issues with her company. I made a purchase to buy a couple lip kits, which I did. I must have forgotten that on top of their shipping rates, which are ridiculously overpriced, I ended up having to pay a tax fee once I received my package. So this time when I picked up my order, or when it got delivered, they charged me a tax fee, which was unreal, but whatever. So anyways, I picked up a couple of lip kits. I am, decently impressed. I do have Dolce K, Candy K, and Ginger. I think those were the three that I owned. Dolce K, Candy K, and Ginger. And then I have two of her lip glosses, which, I mean, eh. Her lip glosses are meh to me. I prefer her liquid lip kits. So anyways, I had my eye on the Kylie's Royal Peach palette and Dirty Peach liquid lipstick for the longest time. Probably since Dirty Peach released last spring, because that's when Dirty Peach originally released. So I kind of wanted to pick it up. I wanted to wait. It's my birthday this month in April, so I figured this was the time to pick it up for my birthday as a treat. And when I did, I wanted to get enough product to make my shipping charge worth it, because $14.95 American is like almost pretty much $20 Canadian, and that's a lot for shipping, especially when like the states were like sisters. Canada and the states are sisters, so for that type of fish shipping cost was kind of it's kind of unreal. Anyways, she used to have like $60 or over international shipping free, but I don't know what happened. I guess that didn't stay very long. So I finally bit the bullet and I picked up the Kylie Royal Peach palette. It came as a kit. So you get the Kylie Royal Peach palette, and then you got the Apricot liquid lipstick. So it was kind of nice because I really wanted peachy colors for springtime, and I didn't really have too many peachy colors, only because I had more like hot pinks and like pinks like this. So I didn't really own a lot of like peachy lipsticks and peachy eyeshadows. Like that was never in my collection. And when I made the decision to buy the Kylie Royal Peach palette, it was basically the decision between the Royal Peach palette or the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. I wanted to kind of, it was either one or the other. And to be totally honest, the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette was just not enough peaches in that palette for me, and I wanted to buy a palette with a lot of peachy colors. So this is the one that I ended up going to, because the price of the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette was basically equivalent to the price of the Royal Peach palette and the Apricot lip kit together. So I was getting, you know, an extra product, an extra two products combined with the set that they were offering online. I did make my purchase on Kylie Cosmetics, so that's where I went to buy it. This is a authentic Kylie product. It's not like I went on Amazon or a third party vendor. This is straight from Kylie Cosmetics. I have to say I've used this now maybe two or three times, and I really do love the peachy colors. The peachy colors are gorgeous. The shimmery shadows, which the only two that I've tried so far are this gold and like this light bronze, like very, very light bronze. Those two are not as pigmented as I wanted them to be for a shimmer. But the royal blue is beautiful. And these peachy shades here, and this peachy shade, and this peachy shade, and then this neutral matte brown is beautiful too. So, I mean, the two golds, the gold and the bronze, light bronze is like, it was all right. What is this called? I think it's called Seashell? Yeah, this is called Seashell. And this one is called Mojito. So Seashell and Mojito are not really my favorite, only because they're not as pigmented as I wanted them to be, but the other ones are pretty decent and they're pretty good. So, you know, I just wanted something peachy. That's all I was asking for. And unfortunately, the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette just did not have enough peach color for me in that palette. And I wasn't going to spend $60+ on that palette when there was only one peach shade. You know what I mean? So I ended up opting for the Kylie one. I'm glad that I did. Some people don't like this palette. They don't like how it blends. They don't like how it works. It does come with a Kylie brush, like a blending brush, which is over there because I've already used it. The brush is good. It's stiff enough where it does blend out everything properly. I think that it's a decent palette. A lot of people said they complained about the smell. It doesn't really have, like, mine doesn't have that major chemically smell. And when I first bought it, like when it first came in the mail, that was the first thing I did. When I opened it up, I wanted to see how bad the smell was. The chemical smell was not that bad. Like, you don't smell it when you're using it normally, like you would when you're doing a look. If you actually go really close to the actual pans and you sniff, you really smell a very faint chemical smell, very faint. And I think it's not even the shadows, it's how they mentioned that the way the packaging was put together, that is pretty much what it is you smell. They said to leave it open for maybe a day or so and that smell would go away. But to me, the smell doesn't really bother me because it's not that strong. It's just the glue that, you know, kept the palette together. I'm not really bothered by it. Some people don't like the fact that there's a little bit of that chemical smell, but I mean, what are you going to do? It's the glue keeping the cardboard, you know, together, or else this palette would fall apart, you know? As for the shades, like the shadows, like I don't, like when I pick it up from on my brush and I smell the brush, there's no chemical smell on the shadows at all. So the people who are too picky, then, you know, too bad, so sad, but I think it's a pretty decent palette. I mean, it's not, I wouldn't say it's like an amazing palette like my Tarte palettes are, but you know, for the trend that's in right now, the peach trend, you know, $45 for the palette is not too, too bad. I mean, Too Faced comes out with palettes that are $60 and there's only one peach shade in it. Whereas the Kylie one, you can get for cheaper and you get a more variety of peachy colors, you know? So, even the pan sizes are 1.40 grams per pan. So that's 1.40 grams. Which is like, it's 0.05 ounces per pan. So, I mean, they could be a little smaller, but I don't really care. I'm not going to go through a full palette in my lifetime, so what do I give a shit, you know? But I wanted to show you that I did pick up the Apricot lip kit came with it, and then I picked up, with that order, the Dirty Peach lip kit, because I just been wanting Dirty Peach for so long, and this was my opportunity to pick it up. So, these are the two that I picked up. Here is what Apricot looks like on my skin. I've been wearing Apricot in a couple of my Instagram pictures, so if you're interested into seeing the way that it looks on my face with a full face of makeup, then check out my Instagram. It's linked down below for you guys to check it out. So here's the lip liner. It is a really, really pretty color. The weird thing though about this apricot lip color is that I find that it's a little more drying than her other lip kits. I don't know why, but that's what I'm noticing after using it a few times. So yeah, great swatch, Antonetta. So here's a lip liner. Here is the apricot liquid lip, and I like the color is gorgeous. It's hard for me to find a color that is very identical to Kylie's colors, but the color is beautiful. It's basically like a peachy pink undertone type of shade. It looks beautiful, especially on tan skin. I've been wearing it a couple times again, like I said, in pictures, and it looks gorgeous. The problem with this is that I find that this apricot shade, this shade formula, is very drying. So it's more drying than her other liquid lipsticks. Her other liquid lipsticks I don't have a problem with, but for some reason this one is just extra drying. Even her lip liner for this is not as creamy as her other ones are. So I'm just kind of wondering if maybe either I got a bad batch or it's because of the actual shade, the way that this shade is formulated, that it's super, super, super drying. For me, I'm a liquid lipstick lover. I don't mind the dryness of a liquid lipstick, but this is like over the top drying, where like I can put on the liner, fill in my lips, put this on, and within like 10 to 15 minutes, my lips are cracking. Like the product is cracking on my lips. So I'm still trying to figure out how to use this. I tried filling in my lips with the liner fully and then putting on my one coat. And then I tried just lining my lips fully and then putting on the one coat. And still, I find that it's still kind of sinks into my fine lines, it breaks down, it cracks. I'm very surprised because her other liquid lipsticks don't really do that to me as much. So, I don't know. It's a beautiful color, you guys. I really can't. The only reason I picked it up is because it was part of the kit. Like, you would get the Kylie palette, the Royal Peach palette, with the apricot liquid lipstick in a bundle. So it was bundled that way. I didn't pay extra for it. It was part of the bundle, and that's why I picked up the bundle, because it was worth more the bundle than just getting the palette alone. So I mean, I love this color. I'll definitely continue to wear it and try to figure out how to wear it, but I don't know what it is. It's just super drying. More super drying than her other ones. Like the Dirty Peach lip kit, which has become my favorite, you guys. Like I cannot describe to you. The Dirty Peach lip kit has become my favorite. Like, it is unreal. It is super unreal how much of a favorite this has become. Like, I have no words how much this has become my favorite. It's definitely not as drying as the apricot lip kit. I'll tell you that right now. I mean, any liquid lipstick that's matte is going to be a more drier formula. But I have to say that the Dirty Peach lip kit is up to par with her other liquid lipsticks. That's Dirty Peach and that's the liner. So I don't know what it is, but the apricot one is just super, super drying. The Dirty Peach one is more comfortable for me to wear. I don't know why. I just think maybe it has to do with the color formulation. Some different color formulations can be slightly different, especially when you're mixing, trying to make a certain color. So I think because, this is a different formulation than this one because of the color concept of it, that could be why. So I mean, would it stop me from buying from her again? No. I mean, if another color comes out that I want to try, which there is a few more colors, I'd like to try her Velvet liquid lip kits. And there's a couple colors I'd like to try from there. I'm gonna go ahead and try them out. They're pretty decent. I really do like them. The Dirty Peach one has become my favorite. I used to, between Candy K and Dolce K, those were my top two nudes from her. And then Ginger I used quite a bit in the fall time because it's a perfect fall color. And Dirty Peach now has become my favorite spring. I do love Apricot as well. Apricot is so pretty. Just the wearability is really tough for me to wear, especially if I'm going out and I'm eating and I'm, talking and, my lips are moving. So you're gonna see my lines, you're gonna see fine lines and all that. I think what I might do with the apricot one is I might wear some sort of intense lip hydrating mask underneath and then apply that, and then apply the liquid lip and see if that helps with the hydration issue. Because I've worn liquid lipsticks before, and especially her other ones, they don't give me that problem that the apricot one does. So I'm just being honest with you guys. That's my findings of my new products, the ones that I've tried anyways. So Dirty Peach, yes, has become my favorite, my ultimate favorite. I'm in love with that. I've been into a lot of peaches lately. I think it has to do with just spring, the trend. For all we know, the peach trend might fade off next spring. It might continue for next spring. It might continue for a few springs from now. We don't know, but it's temporary, it's makeup, you can always take it off, like everybody says here on YouTube. So that is it, you guys. That was my haul. I think it's a little bit of a longer haul because I've been really chatty. But, you know, whatever the case is, I like talking to you guys, so it's really great talking to you. So if you have any comments to the products I've shown you here, if you've tried any of the products, if you have any opinions on the products that you've tried, let me know down below. I would be interested to see what you guys have to say with the products you've tried out from this group of stuff that I've shown you here. And don't forget to like this video, subscribe if you're not. I would love for you guys to come back. This is my YouTube family. I love my YouTube family. You guys are amazing. I just love being able to talk to you guys about what I'm passionate about, and that's what this YouTube platform really means to me. So thanks so much again for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, everyone. Mwah.